Hello everybody and welcome to Chaos Gamers HD. It's me, Nicholas here, and I'm on the Bedcraft server, which is an FTB server that we play on. I'm actually going to be streaming in probably a few hours. I'm going to go out to get something to eat. My father going out for lunch, but I wanted to record a video here, just kind of giving you guys a tour of the city and my plans and stuff like that. But this is going to be a series on this channel, so I hope you guys enjoy it. Anyway, so this is our city. This is what we're looking at here. Let me go over here. Sorry, sometimes this server, like the chunk loading and stuff like that, is a little bit off. Let me just do that. Okay. So this is the barn that is our current project at the moment. We're still working on it. We're gonna have the wheat kind of go all over the mountains and stuff like that. Make it look like a barn. We're gonna have make this a little bit more functional. So I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of a tip for when it comes to building, and you guys are probably like, you know, if you played on the same server for so long, you start to run out of ideas or inspiration for builds. But the best advice I can give you guys is actually making a big build and adding function to it. Now, what I mean by adding function to it, so this is a barn, right? So barns, what do? Like, you know, they or not barns, but like farms. Let's say this is like a farm area. This is the barn. What do they do? Okay, so what farms usually do is they pretty much, you know, farm any type of crop that they have in season, or, you know, all year round. It depends on where you're from. So right now we got wheat, right? So we got wheat all around here. We got some corn. We're probably going to add more vast amounts of corn, because that's a kind of a nice little thing. Carrots and potatoes, and some watermelons, but, you know, that's optional to add different types. But we're going to say the main function for this farm here is the wheat, okay? So obviously when you grind up wheat, you make flour, and with flour you can make bread and stuff like that. Am I right? Am I wrong? Okay. So by doing this big build, it automatically adds... like, if we add function to it, it gives us more and more projects to do. So, I was running out of a little bit of inspiration for this build here. I've been on the server for a few weeks here. I actually took a trip to Maine for a week to get out of the state. But when you add function to a build, you kind of add more ideas and more things you can do. So right here, I'm adding a place for a potential windmill marker. I usually mark down everything with signs, so I don't forget where the placement is supposed to go, and I kind of just map out the area, and I just build on it. So right over there is a windmill, but it's not functioning. It's, you know, the windmill is going back, and, you know, obviously it's, let me put my, there we go. So flight control's on. You can see that it moves very slowly, and let me turn off my flight control. So you come in here, it's a non-functioning windmill, but what I mean by that, we're not using this power for anything. The reason for that is that there's windows right here, and we can actually bring these wires down and make this like a hub for, you know, just at least use a little bit of power, maybe hook it up to a tesseract or something like that, you know what I mean? Just kind of add it to the central hub for more power. We can make it to MJs or whatever we need it for. But right now it's non-functioning. Over there, I'm going to make a functioning windmill. And we're going to make it pretty tall. It's going to be a little bit, probably a lot taller than that one. And we're going to make it go up. What I mean by we, I have a 4-man team. So me, Austin, which is the one that made the Ark Survival Evolved video. He's going to be making the Ark videos. I'm probably going to be making these Minecraft videos, or, you know, Borderlands 2 or something like that. All depends. Just let me know in the comment section down below what games you're going to be interested in, and we're going to kind of try and make a schedule and follow it, because I haven't uploaded a video in a while, mainly because I've been busy streaming, and usually streaming, I stream for about 3 hours. So that takes up a lot of my day, and also figuring out what I want to do for the builds for my next project is also a task and a half right there. But yeah, so adding functions. So adding a windmill, right, will give, you know, this power, and then we can add even a water mill on the side of it. To add more power. And what we can use that for is we can use it for, you know, adding it as almost like a grinding station over here, right? And then we can add, like, you know, mine carts underground, like shafts and stuff like that actually carry the flour to the nearest, boom, extra project, bakery, bam. So we can have a bakery full of, you know, bread and stuff like that. And just adding function to your builds can add a sporadic train, I don't even know what you want, like sporadic tree of ideas that you have. And just apply those ideas to your city in the right spots and you'll keep on building forever. I promise you that. Right here is a bridge that we decided to scrap a couple days ago because it was not the bridge that I was looking for, and this one's more of a more symmetrical bridge right here. My bridge was kind of a little bit, like, you know, crooked in some spots and stuff like that, and it kind of tangled around, but when you know, when you don't add symmetry to some things, like let's say bridges, sometimes the supports can come out weird, and it just didn't look right, it didn't fit in well with the build. And that's kind of, it was bugging me for a little while, because when you're not happy with the build that you do in Minecraft, and you're a builder like I am, it gets a little bit irritating to see, you know, a nice city that you work a lot of time on, and you just have this piece of crap bridge that connects, you know, village to village, I guess you could say, because this is its own separate peninsula, or not peninsula, sorry, just like its own separate piece of land, and then we got a landlocked, landlocked island. It was just the right size to actually add a windmill, and this is my bee house right here, and someone left me a nice surprise, one of my other tech guys. So we have two tech guys, which is Austin, nice honeycombs is producing, we got Austin, and we got Mike. And they're both really cool dudes, but I woke up this morning to see all of this, and I was asking him the night before, or last night, sorry, how I use all these blocks, and he said that I would be helping and stuff like that, but his internet was, you know, having problems and stuff like that, and then me and Austin decided to hang out for a little bit, and then I kind of just went offline for a bit, to wake up to this morning to see a whole chest full of just serum. So that's amazing. If you guys don't know what that is, basically you extract certain traits out of bees. So let's see if I have. Okay, so see how. Okay, so this one's already bee-alized. So there's a Valiant drone right here. So it says Valiant Steadfast Hybrid, which means that it's a Valiant and a Steadfast Hybrid, which is a mix. It's a slow worker, normal life, but if you look down, it's nocturnal. Now, the reason why that's a good thing is because having a nocturnal trait means that it can work all the time. It can work at night and during the daytime, so that's really good, because sometimes, as you can see, this Meadows Queen right here will not produce anything during the night, because it says not daytime. That's just pretty much the simple way of putting it. So you can extract the nocturnal trait in this, and say you got a really good bee in the future, you can actually inject a serum, which is these little vials right here, and when you inject a serum into, like, say, like a Meadows Queen, now it becomes nocturnal, it can work all the time. So we have an apiary right here. I potentially want to make this bigger in the future, like make actually like this house, make something like out of it, and actually move my bee stuff to a bigger location where I can have many apiaries and stuff like that, just all running at the same time and have a mass production of just bees, because bees are actually really good to have in FTB Ultimate. Anyway, so yeah, adding function to your build is my number one tip for builders and stuff. So this right here is the main house. Okay, it doesn't really look like it because you're like, oh, you got a windmill right here, you got a mansion over there. Why would you need like this little small little ship for the main house? Well, I'll show you. So this was just the first build that I built to actually start off the city. I kind of planted some wheat around over here to kind of add a little bit of color to it. And I already had people in my stream already like throwing their arms at me like, hey, why do you you know, you're using FTB Ultimate where it has plenty of different blocks and you're using all vanilla blocks to make your first house. And I don't know, I just, something about oak wood and just the vanilla wood blocks I just really like. Doesn't mean I don't like the new wood blocks or anything like that, it's just I like the vanilla, I'm a vanilla kind of person, vanilla player. But anyway, so we've got a windmill, or watermill, sorry, right here that's non-functional. And then you go down the stairs, and this is our central hub of power and everything. So I don't know what happened here, because I replaced all the overclockers because I was playing around with plasma guns. And basically, this can destroy machine blocks in a radius of however the blast is. So when you're in the basement here, you know, We got deep storage units. We got a tree farm over here. We got MJ converters and just a bunch of stuff. Austin, again, is a tech guy, so he'd be better at explaining this stuff than I am. Is this the ME terminal? Okay, I guess he moved it. That's why I was, like, really confused. And we're going to do something right now. But I'll show you the rest of this. I'm just going to grab some bone meal for a later thing. In here, we got our nether room. So kind of trying to make it look like the nether. We got a secret room somewhere that we won't show you guys for a really long time. Anyways, we got some soul forges. But here's some cool things here. We got a farm, like mob farms and stuff like that. So we obviously got the creeper thing going, and Austin's really good. Well, I wouldn't say really, really good, but he's pretty good at programming things. So this is a touchscreen monitor right here, and if I select blaze on this side, the blaze spawner will be activated. And you can just turn it off by clicking it again. And it's just a really cool farm. I really like that touchscreen because it's just like, oh, I need some blaze rods, so you just click on the blaze and boom. Down here we have another floor full of just random stuff. So blast furnace. Right here is, I believe these are engines that constantly pump out MJs. And through here you can actually just, I can't actually access this, so I can't really tell you what they what the output is, like how much they, maybe I can do it like that. Yeah, combustion engine. Okay. Let me put my Skype on do not disturb. I apologize about that, guys. Anyway, so yeah. And then you got a tesseract coming over here, and then down over here you got like the tree farm, so you can manage it and stuff like that if anything ever breaks. And you got all of this. I don't know what this is. Oh yeah, this is what Austin's been busy with. Oof. Wow, this is, Austin's been working really hard lately on creating a bigger room to store all of our machines and power. So if y'all, this was big. I don't know if you guys just saw that, but that's pretty crazy. Anyway, and then we got an anchor right here, I believe. It's a world anchor. Okay. To keep that chunk loaded. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That's just me giving you guys a tour. In later date and time, I'm actually going to be doing projects and stuff like that on here. But for now, that was just, you know, just kind of give you guys a little bit of a thing. This right here, this house has no function to it. Literally no one lives here, and I haven't actually gotten to creating the internal design of it. So, I mean, everything is just kind of, yeah, I was planning on doing it, but got lazy because it's a big build, so takes a lot of my time, and if no one's going to live here and this has no function to it, might as well work on other projects that I have in mind. Anyway, so hope you guys have a good day. Make sure to like, comment, and favorite the video. Favoriting still a thing? make sure to subscribe to the channel for new content every week, and we'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out, everybody.